Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Docs Da Vinci.
Young Lion in the motherfucking building. What's the word?
Today we're doing something that we haven't done before, but hopefully if it goes well, we will do it more often. As you see on the screen, we got the new Chris Brown album,
Breezy,
dropped yesterday. And we wanted to do a review. So I haven't listened to it yet. This nigga couldn't wait.
One time, it was 5 in the morning. One time through. One run. Since then,
mind you, this was his idea. He said, yo, let's do an album review. I said, I bet. I'll wait to listen to it.
I don't even know why he's doing this. It's Breezy, bro.
He said, all right, I'm gonna listen to the first 5 songs.
Niggas know what it is.
By the end of the day, this nigga said, bro, 20 straight, no skips. Which I believe, because, yeah, it is Breezy. You know what I'm saying?
And he's shown that he's capable of doing 30, 40. Mind you, all right, if I'm gonna be tough, nigga, Like with the 40 track albums and shit, you could probably say like half of it was fire, like, and then that's still like really good regarding, like, you know, like an album output. Like, if you say half of a 40 something track album is fire, that's good.
I like a lot of Chris Brown's like long projects, but what I do is I'll listen to like half of it the first 6 months of the year, and the next 6 months I'll listen to it. It's like having two completely different drops,
and you find a lot of hidden gems through, like, too.
Yeah, but I liked Heartbreak on a Full Moon. I liked
Indigo.
So I have, you know, high expectations for this album. I feel like it's going to deliver. I've tried to avoid any spoilers or anything, any reviews, critiques, comments, so I can have a completely clean slate going into this album. But enough talking. I know you've been ready to listen to this shit all day.
Yeah, man. I'm going to give it another run through.
So first song's called Till the Wheels Fall Off, which everyone has told me is a banger.
You heard it. You just didn't hear this one, this version. You heard it. That's the video I showed you, the 2-minute video when he's like with the jacket on and the microphone's outside.
Oh, yeah. I completely wiped that from my brain.
Yeah. So. Yeah, good. See? That's good. That's what I'm saying, bro. That's good.
All right. So let's get into it. Till the Wheels Fall Off. So what we're going to do is we're going to listen to the first 6 songs. End this episode, and then part 2 will go from track 7 to 12, and then track 13 to 18, and then 19 to 24. 4 parts, break this album up. I don't want to listen to 24 songs straight in one episode. We'll be here forever. Yeah. So,
right. And I'm going to be extremely objective, too. Like, where I'll critique, like, which I could think he could have, I mean, like, executed better on. And I'll try, even though I don't think it's possible.
And for those of you new here, returning here, haven't subscribed yet, please hit the subscribe button. Smash the like button if you are enjoying this content, so we know that you want more of it.
It's Docs and Young Lion, nigga, what you mean? Get with it.
Alright, till the wheels fall off. Let's get it, Breezy.
Bro. Pause. Like, what I like, though, like, what he does extremely well is the switch-ups in his music, bro. Like, it starts one way, and you just expect it to just be that way, and then that nigga just fucking just, all right, go ahead.
This nigga's gonna give me spoilers.
Summertime, but it feels cold. Sun's out, it ain't shining, no. I'm just trying to make it through the day. Ain't thinking about tomorrow. As I lay me down to sleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep. Cause there's darkness all around me. Told my brother we gon' slide. We gon' ride.
I like how he makes hard R&B music. Like,
yeah, bro. Yeah. Like, he makes, like, he's singing. R&B. Yeah, this nigga's singing right now, bro, while rapping, bro. Like, it's crazy. Like, he's too talented.
Like, he does the melodic shit that these rappers do, but he can really sing, so it's different.
Yeah, bro. It's nice.
Shot my nigga Bobby 5 times. I was hella hurt. Caught up in some politics.
Now we on some wild shit. I just wanna see my niggas on without the candle lit. Most my niggas learn how to get money but can't manage it. Couple of my bitches say the word and I'ma handle it. If my heart break, no compensation for the damages. I done got it out the mud, that shit was uncomfortable. Mama worked a 9 to 5, she left me 5 Lunchables. All them guns, your ass be posting, niggas still touchable. Had to pull the shoe out the bucket just to find a matching shoe. All the hoop niggas wanna rap and all the rap niggas wanna die. They ain't wanna post cause they do the most at them computers. They like how you ain't GD and your daddy was under Larry Hoop.
Yo, Lil Durk, whenever he gets like, I know Lil Durk is grown from like the past 10 years being in the game and shit, and he has his cult fan base. Back. But like, now that he's getting on these features with like Drake, stars, DJ like, Khaled, yeah, Chris Brown, he's superstars. Like, he gets in a different bag when he goes
there.
Yeah,
he do.
And I fuck and with
in the
it.
Presence of like real, like musical, like legendary people, like he ups the ante. Like he usually do that for him.
Yeah, now he's delivering right now. Yeah.
I be on a trip and grab a whip and then I slide off. You know I'm a tour, stop going live and throw my vibe off. I done wrote the jail and I was on the floor like take some time off. He said no cause I kept smiling in my mugshot.
I'm interested to hear what Capella's gonna do.
Yeah, it's for completely his different, bro. Different nigga. His lane is gonna be
don't watch what we do. Same gang with me since Robbins and Truth. Bluffing ain't no way hard to find. We been outside, posing on the stoop. That's why we're no business, but what they might do on the internet. Posting for the ops to watch, now when I enter that. They know what it is, them CV they don't try. Fine by me, spinning we gon' slide.
Before we get into the next song, I really fuck with it.
Capella Gray, 1 to 5, we still gotta do that.
So, write it down, but I wanna wait to reveal that until, like, we go through all the songs. And then we'll do the ratings afterwards.
Yeah, I already know what I'm
gonna say. I bet. I wrote down what I got for a star rating for this one already. I really fuck with this song. Strong intro. I've only heard Capella Gray up until this point on, like, boppy shit. Like, I've heard him on Gallus, you know, his shit with Russ. What's this? Is it Dream Doll or Cash Doll? Dream Doll.
Yeah.
They have that record together. So I've really only heard them in one lane. So when I heard the beat and then I heard what Chris Brown and Lil Durk did, I was like, I could hear them doing that. Like, they did what they were expected to do. Well, Chris a little bit more. I think he bodied that hook. But then like, I was like, knowing what I know about Capella Gray, I was interested to hear how he was going to like match their style. And I think he found a dope pocket and ran with it.
He
so.
Made it his own.
Yeah, I was definitely nervous about that being, like, the weakest verse of the song. But, like, when you go last, it's, like, the anchor spot. So, yeah, like...
You gotta hold that shit down. And then, like, the thing is, like, the only critique I have for this song is, like, I love Durk's part. But, like, the fact that they had two singers on that, I feel like if they would have probably... If it was Black or some shit like that, you feel me?
Oh, Black would have smoked
this. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, if it was just three singers on there rapping, that would have been insane. Or even Tory. Tory would have destroyed this.
Oh, Tory would have walked all over this shit.
It would have been fucking crazy, too. But nah, Durk did phenomenal. I love this song.
Yeah, if you weren't going to do two singers, you could have done, like, Durk and Lil Baby.
Yeah, Baby would have been crazy on that shit, too. Yeah, facts.
All right, so the second song is called C.A.B., Catch a Body, featuring Favio Foreign. Favio's been on a little run this year.
Super run. Dropped his album. Like it did okay for this time.
He was on
times.
The Kanye album.
He's
been on a couple of big singles.
He's being kind of basically pushed as like the guy out of New York that's like holding it down since Pop.
Yeah, he's like kind picking of up where he left off with that sound. So, I'm interested again to see how these are gonna like. The feature list is crazy to me. Like, got Lil Baby, I see Lil Wayne, Wizkid. So I'm interested to hear the direction of the project, hearing the intro now, where it's gonna go. Catch a body.
Yeah. She know the demon coming to party, bro.
Bow, nigga. Fuck me.
Mama, you said she wanna say that she on the power. She understands she gotta give, she wanna glow. Crashing the whip, whiter than snow, fresh out the boat. She tryna fly, now we on the draft, so we're in Dubai.
I'll say it again. Bro, the melody shit rappers do is cool, but when you got a real singer doing this shit, it's not even comparable.
It's not fair. Yeah,
it's not even fair, bro.
It's like, yo, bro, it doesn't matter what kind of tempo you give this nigga, bro. If he just knows how to just construct the chorus for it, he's knocking it out the park. It doesn't matter what the fuck it is, bro. He's knocking it out the park. Insane. Insane talent, bro. I got a feeling we finna be glow. I got a feeling you already know. Baby, let me take control. You ain't gonna be solo no more. No, you see me. I stop for the party. Shots got me feeling saucy tonight. If I fuck your girl, I'm not sorry. No, I ain't cuffing anybody tonight. I'm on go, go. Cause I can fuck with anybody tonight. I'm on go, go. I'm just trying to get your body tonight. I got it on me when I link her. She like that. She want me to fuck her, I might pass. But I still fell in love with her nice ass. I see an op, he sees a gun and light flash. Bow! They know I'm in love, but I'm still a demon. You better not give me a mic back. And we don't kiss when we in front of the bros. I let her party and come to the show. She been through the worst, she ain't even fold. Send your man's hat, he ain't even blow. Yeah, I'm one of a kind, ain't too many mo. That shit I've been through made me grow. I got a feeling we finna be grow. I got a feeling you already know. Control. You ain't gonna be solo no more. No more. No, you see me. Crazy. That's the second song, bro. Like,
that's a solid follow-up record. It's definitely not like, you know, the most creative song I've ever heard from.
No, that's just the bop.
Yeah, like, no, it's a bop for sure.
I feel like it could have been shorter too.
Yeah, I was gonna say it was a little lengthy. Of a song.
Could have been shorter.
Favio's verse was just average to me. I've definitely heard him go
hard.
Yeah,
harder. That was regular Favio.
Yeah, that would be.
Like, there's certain, like, Bobby songs where, like, you always tell me it's, like, less is more. Like, yeah. You always say, like, sometimes. So it's, like, that one is just, like, it's a pretty, like, good follow-up for, like, it's easing you into the shits. Like, after, like, a strong thing, it's, like, all right, now he's, like, gonna cruise.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? Just let you, like, gradually...
And plus, on a 24 song album, even on a 15 song album, I'm not expecting all of them to be 5-star records. So
I really liked it.
No, it's
just because it's like that's the first drill song that I heard Chris on, like drill.
It's
like,
a drill vibe.
Yeah.
I just feel like the.
Maybe but it could have been. It's too long. I don't like it being that long though.
And like maybe I'm having a tough time trying to figure out what genre this is. Like it's drill but poppy and like I don't know. It's tough to, like, settle your ear on a specific, like,
I think that's,
way to listen to it.
Like, that's no, like New York, that's like Brooklyn. It sounds like Brooklyn drill to me. Like what Favi usually be, like, rapping on type shit.
Yeah, the drums for sure. But the just overall, like, aesthetic of the song, it's like a pop song combined with a drill song. So it's, like, kind of tough to figure out where it's going to go. But it's a vibe. I would definitely, like, listen to it again. Drive around listen to that song. Alright, so song number 3 we got, it's called Pitch Black. This is the first song that he doesn't have a feature on. First solo Chris Brown record. Let's see how he carried it. Fell in love with the lights off. I ain't sure with the lights off. Alligator with the bright thong. Fell in love in the pitch black, loving my baby. We all look the same. Hey, with the lights off, lights off, in the pitch black, loving my baby. Here we go. Take it off of me, baby. Here we go. In the pitch black, loving my baby. Here we go. In the pitch black. Oh, my cat wants to join the video.
Hello, kitty.
Now. I like that song. That's definitely outside music.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, I'm definitely going to add that to the playlist. Yeah.
The reason why I really like this song is because it takes me back to, like, X. Like, his album, like, that vibe. Like, 2014.
Like, it brings me to, like, a specific time, and it's just, like, super vibey, like...
Like, I know if this song sounds okay just chilling in the room, now I'm saying that when I go outside and play it in the whip, mm-hmm. when I'm around women and the song comes on, like, yeah. definitely this song is to be played around women.
Yeah.
Here we go. Yeah, no, it's a vibe. I like where this album's going so far. Chris Brown usually, like, within the first quarter of his projects, because... Last album was like 30 something songs.
32?
Yeah, the one before that was like 40 something.
47. 45.
I'm impressed that you know that off the top without looking. But usually within like the first, you know, 25-33% of a Chris Brown project, I got a song where I'm like, nah, that's my fucking shit. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna keep going back to that album. I don't care how old the album gets. I don't know if this one is it yet per se, but it's definitely up there.
It's the so it's it for now, basically. You're saying.
Yeah. I could definitely see myself going back and listening to it again. I don't know if it's gonna be the one that I'm like, this is the first one that and only, like, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. but
and for it being three, that's pretty good. The third song for you to have.
No, definitely. Yeah. And but like I'm going trying to think back, like Heartbreak on a Full Moon, I liked Hope You Do is Hope like you my do is shit.
Insane. Yeah.
And then on
Indigo,
it was Red.
Yeah.
So, I'm not saying that this song is on that level yet necessarily, but we'll see how it ages and we'll see what else is on this album. I might hear something in a couple songs that's like, oh, nah, this is the one. You know what I mean? But the next song is called Possessive, featuring Lil Wayne and Blue.
Young Blue.
I always look for Young.
Yeah.
He changed his name. I know this is gonna be fire because last time Young Blue and Chris Brown collabed, it was a smash.
It's
Wheezy, anytime he's with Chris Brown, it's a smash. So Little I'm Wayne already will expecting.
Never, listen, Lil Wayne will never not be a top five rapper, dead or alive, for as long as he lives. The fact that he could still do this, it's crazy. Let's get money.
This shit sounds like a Drake beat off rip.
When you love someone, you can feel it in your bones. Try to do what he never did, set the tone. I remember we was at war when I slept alone. I wrote this shit for the most beautiful love that I ever known. I was trying to bag you, sending you signals like say your phones. He trying to drag you, fucked up your feelings, left you alone. But are you bragging? You found a nigga you can count on.
Yo, Blue's that nigga.
Yo, he's talented.
Yo, he can sing, but his lyrics, yo, right. I really be fucking with how Blue writes.
And he, yo, bro.
Assuming that he writes his shit.
Every single feature I've heard from this nigga so far has been outstanding.
Every single song I've heard from this nigga. Yeah,
outstanding. Like, he's just, it's just bomb.
That's why I fucking love Young Blue, whatever he goes by now. Like, I love his music because of the lyrics. He's dropping bodying
bombs.
This shit.
Yeah, he's dropping bombs, bro. Every track.
Yeah. I wonder, do your mama remember me? She was talking down on me, switching your energies. I got you falling like winter leaves, perfect synergies.
It's like I just said about when rappers do the melody shit, and Chris Brown, obviously one of the elite
singers. He's one of them.
Chris, like, Young Blue, I think he's even better at rapping than he is singing, probably. Yeah, no, he is. So,
I think
when he gets into these melody pockets, like, he can sing. He can really flex these melodies.
You can say he's a rapper that know how to sing a little bit. Yeah, like, he knows how to put it together real well. Like, when he probably writes his R&B songs, like, he's writing just, like, raps. Like, he's writing real raps, but he just knows how to sing that shit like that.
Right,
like,
that's what I'm saying. That melody shit, that's why melody shit sound cool. That's why, like, artists like, you know, Lil Baby, fucking Gunna, Young Thug, like, artists that use the melodic shit.
Roddy Ricch,
even Drake, like, you know what I mean? They use that as a lane. It's a legitimate lane. But when you're an actual singer, like, you can just wake up in the morning and start doing riffs and shit.
That's what Chris was saying on the Million Dollars Worth of Game interview. He's basically saying, like, yo, like he wasn't trying to be cocky, but he was like, yo, he doesn't really necessarily, like, when it comes to R&B, he doesn't necessarily see anybody in his lane because of all that he puts in his show. Like, in this aspect of who he is as an artist, like, the fact that he could, like, he has to dance and sing and perform. Like, there's nobody who has, it's been like 17 years. Nobody since him has been the successor to be the dancer and the singer to be as big or as good or can sing as good or make as good music. Like, he was basically saying, like, nobody's doing that. They're not putting the artistry in the music videos. Like, they're not doing none of the shit. Like being like a real, like, showman. Like, he said nobody's really in his lane. So that's why that pertains to that. Like, he could just hop into some shit and...
No, I have a Chris Brown hot take that I'll save for the podcast. Mm-hmm. This isn't the video for it, but I definitely think Chris Brown is, as talented as he is, he's probably one of the most underappreciated artists that we have. Easily.
Our underappreciated superstars.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, nah, yeah, for sure.
But back to the song.
And I might get a little aggressive, yeah, I might get a little possessive, but you know I got good intentions.
Young Blue used that
note. And even though you play very cool, word on it.
Confession. I'm kind of possessive, your body impressive, your time is too precious. I treat it like a diamond and bezel. I'm trying to protect you, ain't trying to let you out my protection. I'm trying to caress you, these other niggas trying to correct you. I'm trying to just let you be you, baby, I promise no pressure. I honor your presence, see you act like I found me a treasure. And time is the best, and I want you to know mine is invested in our connection. You interesting, I'm interested.
What is Wayne trying to prove? What is he trying to prove?
Bro.
We know you can rap, nigga. Like, chill out.
He's walking on this shit, bro.
Nah, this is like, this is getting me,
take
like,
you out of my protection.
Early 2010s, like, Wayne run.
He's wigging right now, like, bro. Like, that's crazy. I was like, nah, this is ridiculous. Like, this is like a soft, and it's, he's like rapping like hard, but it's, his the lyrics are like, you know what I mean?
This is like that verse he did for Swagger Right with Kerry Hilson.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
it's,
yeah.
It's like,
yeah,
that kind of like just energy. He's just going off.
Nigga's going crazy right now.
That I'm not with the flexing, especially when you out with your besties. I gotta respect it. I sit my ass down, let you check me. It's honestly sexy. You met me, I was not what expected. You mine until the end of time of possession. And I might get a little aggressive, or I might get a little possessive, but you know I got good intention. Good intention. And even though you play very cool, I know that you.
I wouldn't do the same with them I do to you. How come everything I tell you end up in the news? They won't love you when you're down and no answer. We gon' keep that between me, God, and your temper.
Nah, that's a smash.
Insane.
This might be my favorite one of the project so far. Nah, Till the Wheels Fall Off is too crazy.
Yeah.
But this might be number two right now. No cap.
That shit's insane. Weezy just...
I already know once Hit My Line Drop, that's going to be my favorite song off the album. But so far, Till the Wheels Fall Off and Possessive are my go-to. I'm going to run these back and probably listen to them all night.
You said Pitch Black is a good one, too.
It is, but, like, I feel like...
Young Blue did it for you?
All of them. Wayne is elite.
Yeah, he went crazy. He was rap... That was, like, his top-notch, like, type Weezy, like.
And I like how they had Blue there and then took the lyric and flipped it. Like, you made it a hot line, I made it a hot song. Like, that's basically what they did. Yeah, I fuck with it. That's a dope song. So, two more songs for this part of the episode. We got track number 5, Addicted, featuring Lil Baby. Then we're going to get into Call Me Every Day, featuring Wizkid. Then we're going to take a little intermission.
More fire!
So, let's get straight into it. Addicted featuring Lil Baby. I already tell Lil Baby's gonna walk.
Pretty with it, got a few problems, but it's alright, cause she been dealing with them. Sometimes she come and stay overnight, but she ain't living with them. Fuck on somebody from time to time, but she ain't got no nigga. Her last encounter was kinda rough, it made her cry a river. How about you bash from across the globe and get them hand delivered? Get in your mind, don't even know me, I ain't playing with you. I'm being honest, I'm really him, I ain't got a lot of kick. You just come and vibe with me and see if I'm different. I make sure everybody eat, I ain't never been selfish.
I'll make sure everybody eat. I ain't never been selfish.
I made a promise to your body, I'ma stay in no. Put your pennies over there, don't wanna step on them. You know why? Cause I'm addicted to it. Especially when you take it off, nah, baby. Fucking me, breaking me off, nah, baby. So deep in it that I'm lost, nah, baby. Fuck it, don't care what it costs, what it costs, nah, baby.
Coming tonight.
Chains, plain Jane, in the calling and drop by. Waiting to hear you say if you love me or not. Look me in my face so I can tell if you lie. Just say no, you know why? Cause I'm addicted to it. Especially when you take it off, nah, baby. Fucking me, breaking me off, nah, baby. So deep in it that I'm lost, nah, baby. Fuck it, don't care what it costs, nah, baby. Cause now, baby,
yeah.
Coming tonight. Chains, plain Jane, in the calling and drop by. Waiting to hear you say if you love me or not. Look me in my face so I can tell if you lie. This ain't no dance song.
Another average feature verse, I feel like. I've heard him go harder. If this song felt like Chris Brown had it done.
And he just wanted Lil Baby on there.
Exactly. And he just sent it to him and was like.
He's like, oh, I think Lil Baby will sound pretty good on here.
Hell yeah. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, Lil Baby didn't go too extreme.
Yeah, this song would have been way crazier if it was just a solo record by Chris, I feel like. Or if Lil Baby went a little bit harder.
Or if he had another singer on it.
I don't even think the song needed anyone else.
Tank would have been absolutely incredible.
Yeah, Tank would have embodied this.
That's what I'm saying. And they have a great relationship, so it would have been pretty easy for him to do.
But, like, as soon as Chris jumped into the song until the song ended, it was like, all right, it had my full attention, but I was, like, ready to doze off when Baby was rapping. Mm-hmm. But maybe it'll grow on me. This is only my first listen.
Because I'm addicted to it. All
right, so now we got...
This is one of the monsters.
Call Me Every Day.
Yeah. This is one of the monsters.
Call Me Every Day featuring Wizkid. This is going to be the last song that we do for this part of the video.
This is a good end. Like, this is a good... This might probably be one of... This might... This stretch might be the... Like, we should probably rate the parts that we do to see which one, like, which songs is better type shit. Like, you know, like, towards the end.
What do you mean?
Like, you see how we do, we're doing six now and then six and six. Yeah. Like, see which six is better type shit. Like, which six beats who? Like, which part of the album is the best part? Like,
all right, we can do that.
Yeah, part of the album.
All right. So, before we get into this one, make sure you smash the like button as hard as you possibly can.
Please, always.
Obviously, you've only seen parts of the song and the parts that we're reacting to because of copyright reasons. Don't want the whole video to get taken down because we're just streaming his album. Last song for this video... Episode 1, Part 1. Call Me Every Day. More outdoor music.
The sun's in here.
This is what Drake wanted his album to sound
like. Come rewind. Girl, I get the money with you, make you mine. Give you love in every night, you make you mad. Not only you give me love, but make me nice. Nice. I feel make you mine. Girl, I love you, plus I never make you minus. If I let you smoke it, you gon' lose my lighter. If you paranoid, then I'ma spend the night. You can get a loving every day. Diamond eyes on you, the money I go pay. For your love, I go pay, It ain't making my DJs, I feel loaded for you every day. When you call, run it back on replay. For your love, I go pay, For your love, I go play,
Wizkid delivered, like if it's Afrobeat and Chris is gonna get on it, he's gonna body every time. He did it twice with DeVito, or twice with DeVito already. He has another
Afrobeat joint.
Yeah, with Thames, yes, that's the one. Yeah, that he bodied that shit too.
Yeah,
like it's crazy. He has a song on his on the Indigo, the deluxe. It's called Nosedive too. Mm. Like he's
when an artist like Chris Brown, who has like a signature sound. Like you go to the radio or you go to like Pandora or whatever, you hit shuffle on Chris Brown, more than likely a song that's gonna land, you can expect what it sounds like. It's gonna be a great song, but you know like what you're gonna get from Chris Brown. So when he gets into a bag like this and he does what he just did on the song, you know, when an artist does that, and this is just coming from my own personal experience, when an artist steps out of their usual bag and then bodies it like that, they're flexing. It's because they know they can do that. Chris Brown knows at any given point in time,
he can wake up
and just say, I'm going
to
do
that. He could do a whole Afrobeat album.
Chris Brown can make a Honestly Nevermind. He can make a fucking whatever the fuck you want. And do it. He's just flexing at this point. He didn't even need to get WizKid on it. He just did it just to be like, look
what I can get all my superstar friends to just really do this shit, nigga. Like, when that nigga's clear-headed, when he's not, like, in trouble, when he's not, when he's not doing none of the bullshit and the fuck shit's, like, happening, like, when he wants to make music, he gets very artistic with it, bro. And he puts, like, a lot of thought into the shit that he wants to, like, pack into an entire project. So it always comes out very clean. And people don't really... Like, it takes some people to, like, a little bit, because people... Niggas is gonna hate. They're gonna hate Chris. It just goes to show, like, it doesn't matter what it is. Like, he can just... He's a chameleon, bro. Like, that nigga could just wig on whatever.
Yeah. So, my first quarter album review so far is that this... From the beginning, this felt like a statement album. This feels like it's gonna be a statement album. Chris Brown...
He said it. He said he was, like, taking it back. He's like, that's why he didn't really want to do another, like, I mean, like, 30, 40, whatever song. I mean, even though 24 is still a little, it's like, what, an hour and, what, some change? Like, almost 2 hours?
Yeah.
So it's like, he wanted to just say, he's like, no, I'm making, like, music again. Like, he said, like, he was listening to a lot of his old stuff and shit like that. Like, he wanted to get that feeling again. Like when he's, the music he wanted to put into this shit, like, he wanted to give him that feeling. It was like, oh, yeah, I'm about to drop again. And it's like, you know what I mean? It's like...
I feel like he wants, like, I feel like he hears niggas and
they downplay reads, him too, yeah.
Yeah, like, I feel like when people tweet, like, it's about time we say Chris Brown is more talented than Michael Jackson, whether you agree with that tweet or not.
Every song he makes sounds the same.
Yeah, like, I feel like every Chris Brown song sounds the same. He reads that shit and he really, I feel like he thinks he's the greatest and, like, with that comes, like, I gotta do something to set myself apart from, yeah, so I feel like that's what he's trying to do. Like, you guys have this view of me, you guys say that I can't be XYZ, like, I'm gonna show y'all niggas what the fuck I can do.
And you can say,
like even with the name Breezy for an album, it's like
yeah, nigga,
this is me, nigga, like, yeah, this is a statement.
It's like, and people are gonna say, like, oh, no, Chris Brown doesn't have to show that he's talented. It's like, yeah, nah, he does. He does, because he gets slighted a lot, bro.
Yeah.
He does get slighted a lot, like, as much as niggas
don't feel. It's as much as I hate to say it, like, it's the LeBron James thing, because LeBron James is great. Mm-hmm. But, like, I mean, when people downplay LeBron, because it's just, like, when you've been great for so long.
Niggas want to see it, you know what I'm saying?
Niggas just, like, all right, yeah, whatever, Floyd, we get it, Tom Brady, whatever, yeah, we get it, we've seen you do this before, we know how talented you are, like, we get it, but, like, when you're that nigga, it's just, like, nah, like,
sometimes you gotta
give me my fucking flowers, nigga, don't not give me my flowers just because you've seen me do this shit before. If no one else is doing it at my level, we can stop giving me flowers and lower the bar for other niggas, so. Yeah,
you gotta remind them, bro. So he's reminding the fuck out of people on this shit.
So what do you want to do? You want to go song by song, or want me to just go how I, like, my star?
Yeah, we could do song by song.
All right. So for the intro, I gave it 5 stars.
Intro got 5. I did checks. Intro got 5 checks for me.
Cab featuring 504, and I gave it 3.5.
Cab got 3 for me.
I got 3.5 for Pitch Black.
Got 3 for Pitch Black.
Possessive, I gave 5 stars.
I gave 4.
Addicted, I gave 3.
I gave 5 to Addicted.
And Call Me Every Day, I gave 4.5.
I gave 4 to Every Day.
So yeah, I'm instituting half stars because
I only gave Addicted 4 because I felt like it could have, just due to chemistry wise, like, that they've done it before. I feel like if Chris got DeVito on there, it would have sounded just a little bit better. For my ear, it would have sounded just a tiny bit better.
I gave Addicted 3 just because I feel like Baby's Verse really took away from the record.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm instituting half stars because, like, there's going to be songs where I feel like they're not a whole star better than, like, you know what I'm saying? How I did it was I gave Cab 3.5. And then I was going to give Pitch Black a 3, but I genuinely like that song as a song better than the other one. But going off of my scale, I was like, I can't make that lower, so I gave it a 3.5. But if I made it a 4, I don't think that would be a true rating to how I felt about the song. So I'm instituting half stars just for a little bit of middle ground. But yeah, so that's how we have the first quarter of the album. Comment below if you agree with us.
So far, fire, man.
What's your favorite song so far on the album? Like this video. Smash the subscribe button. We'll be back with episode 2, track 7 through 12. Mm-hmm. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The next 6 songs on this Breezy project. And I'm going to try to get these uploaded as fast as possible. So I'm not going to tell you what date. And then when it comes out, like 3 days later, y'all like, nigga, what the fuck happened?
Yeah.
Just keep your eye out. Make sure you subscribe with the notification bell on so
please
you don't miss the episode.
Subscribe.
And we will be back with the next 6 songs. Peace.
Bye.